Jay from Adarsh Model Trains. So today we will see how we can connect a JMRI panel pro with MQTT's message broker. So in the earlier steps we have seen how we can install MQTT message broker, how we can do the configuration, authentication configuration, publishing messages on different topic and subscribing the messages on different topic. So today we're gonna move little bit forward and we'll see how we can connect a JMRI panel pro with MQTT message broker. So first thing what we have to do is we'll start the MQTT server. So here you can see we have I have started that with the Python scripts which we have created earlier, and now what we'll do is we'll open the panel pro. So here you can see the panel pro is open, but before getting into that you can see everything is step by step documented in my GitHub link, which is github.com/adarsh-model-trains in JMRI MQTT spin transformer wireless ecosystem. Here you will go here in the down and you can see JMRI connection setup and testing. So here you can see everything is given step by step. So first thing what we have to do is we have to go to preferences, and here in the connection we'll see where is MQTT. Here MQTT connection IP host, we'll make it localhost, and in the additional here you can see that it runs on 1883 port number which I have given in configuration earlier. MQTT user we have given Adarsh, and password we have given PASSWORD password. So what it does, it for any turnout information it will push it to turnout. So how it gonna be trains/track/turnout will be the topic name, and if we want to send back that information, confirmation information, we can do in the same topic. For sensors we have train/track/sensors, and we can send the sensors information back to the JMRI with the same topic. For light it has tracks train/track/sensors, light, and we can send it back, and reporter topic is track/reporter/. So this is how the simple configuration. And for signal head there is a train/track/signal head, but as of now for signal head and for signal mast JMRI has not implemented any information. So every information for signal head and signal mast is coming under the turnout. So that's the important thing which we have to do, take care. So I have created a Spring application. I'm gonna give in the later video about the description how it will take information from JMRI and how it will segregate the information and post it to the different node wise topics going forward. So that is out of scope for this video, so we're gonna save this here and we'll restart this. So once it will restart, here we can see new client added with Adarsh username, and as of now there is no message. So what we have to do is we have to subscribe to the topic. So basically how we can do subscription, we have seen earlier in the earlier videos how we can do the subscription. There's a this is without username password, and this is Mosquito subscription with username password. So what we have to do is we'll open one more terminal here and we are listening to that now. Here you can see, and what we will do is we'll go to tool So first thing what we'll do is we'll create a light with 1000, and we can create that's other configuration. Just for demo, I'm just creating one light here. So here you can see one light has been created with the address 1000. And if I say on, you can see here light slash on. If I say off, it's getting off. For turnout, we can create a new turnout with the address 10,000 and T 10,000. I have created this here. As of now, it's on unknown position. We'll say close. You can throw it here. You can see. Now we'll go to signal head. We'll create a double output signal head. SHL2. We'll create it with 20,001, 20,002. So we have created. Once we say red, so if you see here, I have just given a couple of space so that you can see clearly. For the red, it will send two information on the, see, I have created 201, 202, and it is giving the information on track slash turnout. And if I say yellow, both will be thrown. And if I say green, again it will be inverted from the first one. And if I say dark, both will be closed. So if we go into triple output SH3, 30,001, 30,002, 30,003, and I'll give some more space here. So here you can see three things are 301, 2 and 3. 301, 2 and 3. And 301, 2 and 3. And if I say it dark, so it's coming on this. But for the sensor, how we can push the information, so what we're gonna do is we'll create a sensor here. Sensor, we'll create a sensor address 1, S1. Created. So here you can see person, but sensor information we have to publish it from. Our side. So how we can do it, if you see here somewhere I have documented that part also. If we go into mosquito setup where we are talking about subscription publishing, publish to just change it to what we have to do is we have to take another new window. So what we're gonna do is we'll minimize this, and here we'll say host username. Okay, this username has to be changed. So here you can see it's active, but here if you go and make it inactive, it will be inactive. And here you can see, because we are reading everything, which starts from slash trains, so we can see information here also. So that's how we can test our configuration with the GMRI. I hope this is gonna help you, because these are the basic steps and which we're gonna need going forward once we are implementing our whole wireless ecosystem by using MQTT, PC 9685 boards and Arduino, as well as NodeMCU. So going forward, I'll give you all the information about each and everything. For this video, I guess that's it.